Hey there, fellow scientists. Welcome back. Hold on. Okay. Welcome back to another... Is that? Ugh. Okay, let's try this again. I thought since we've been talking about Earth's resources lately, it'd be nice to film this lesson at my local park, but all this trash keeps blowing into my frame. How am I supposed to talk about pollution with all this litter around? Ugh, no. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify some of the causes and impacts of pollution. You'll also be able to explain some ways we can reduce pollution. Let's get into it. Pollution is the introduction of harmful materials called pollutants into the environment. Pollutants can be natural, like carbon dioxide or soot from fires, but they can also be artificial, like human-made chemicals or garbage, which we call litter when it's left to clutter up natural and public spaces. Litter and other types of pollution are more than just annoying when you're trying to film a lesson. Pollution can also be extremely harmful. All living things depend on our natural resources, like air and water, to survive. When the health of those resources is harmed by pollution, all forms of life are threatened. Have you ever witnessed litter or other types of pollution? Pause the video here and describe your experience in your guided notes. You may wonder, if pollution is so harmful, why don't we just stop polluting? Well, it's a little more complicated than it first seems. Many of the human activities that create pollution are things we depend on in our daily lives. Vehicles that get us where we need to go emit pollutants. Factories that make important products like medicines and eyeglasses create pollutants. And farms that grow the food we need to live use fertilizers to enrich the soil and produce healthy crops, which, when used in excess, can pollute the ground and water. As you can see, pollution is a complex problem. It's important to understand pollution and its causes and effects so we can work to fix it. Let's take a deeper look at two specific types of pollution: air pollution and water pollution. Air pollution is the presence of pollutants in the air. Sometimes air pollution is visible, like dark smoke puffing out of vehicles or factories. More often, though, pollutants in the air are invisible. The number one source of air pollution comes from burning fossil fuels. You know, those non-renewable resources like coal, oil, and natural gas. For example, many vehicles are powered by burning gasoline, which is made from oil. This releases carbon monoxide, a harmful gas, into the air, along with many other pollutants. Areas with large numbers of cars and factories, such as cities, may even develop smog. Smog is a thick fog or haze of air pollution. Smog can make your eyes burn, cause difficulty breathing, and can lead to serious health issues over time. Although consequences like these are more common in areas like cities, air pollution is not just a local issue. Wind and air currents can carry pollutants long distances, which makes preventing air pollution a global issue. The good news is, if we decide to take action, the effects of air pollution can be improved. For example, in the 1980s, a hole in a part of our atmosphere called the ozone layer was discovered. Scientists determined that chlorofluorocarbons, a type of pollutant found in products like hairspray and refrigerators at the time, were the cause of the hole in the ozone layer. Many governments acted quickly, banning the use of these harmful chemicals. Because of that action, the hole in the ozone layer is on track to be fully healed in the next few decades. This example shows us how taking decisive action can have a huge impact in the fight against pollution. Another type of pollution of global concern is water pollution, which is when any body of water, from freshwater streams to the ocean, is polluted. Some polluted water can look murky with visible pollutants like garbage, but polluted water can also look clean depending on the type of pollutants in the water. Often, water pollution begins on land. When it rains, the water carries loose soil, chemicals from farms and lawns like fertilizers, and even trash into rivers, lakes, and oceans. This is called runoff. Chemicals in runoff can be extremely harmful to the health of aquatic ecosystems. Plastic waste is a major contributor to water pollution. Plastic, which is made from oil, can take hundreds or even thousands of years to break down, which means it often ends up in the ocean. This can harm animals, such as fish or birds that get caught in the plastic waste, or sea turtles that eat plastic bags, mistaking them for jellyfish. Water pollution is a serious problem we've been working to improve on for years. For example, in the 1970s, the US government enacted the Clean Water Act. This law regulated pollutants being put into bodies of water, set water quality standards, and aimed to make all waters safe for fishing and swimming. Since then, the Clean Water Act has led to significant improvements in water quality across the US, cleaning once polluted waters. However, with many water bodies still suffering from pollution, we must remain diligent in our effort to clean the world's water. Because pollution is a problem that affects the whole planet, governments around the world are continuing to make agreements and policies that limit the amount of pollution their countries produce. There's a lot of work left to do on a large scale, but individuals can also have a big impact on combating the effects of pollution. Here are just a couple of small ways you can make a big difference. To prevent trash from reaching oceans and waterways, enlist the help of some friends and neighbors to pick up any litter you can find around your neighborhood. Every bit helps. Emissions from cars are a big source of air pollution. You can help by making choices that keep cars off the road. Ride your bike when you can, organize a carpool, or take public transportation like buses and trains. Shopping locally also reduces air pollution by limiting how far products need to travel. Shopping at farmers markets and stores local to you can help fight pollution. A lot of pollution comes from burning fossil fuels to generate electricity. Remember to turn off your lights and unplug any devices in order to save electricity. Less power used means less needs to be generated. One of the most important things individuals can do to combat pollution is to reduce, reuse, and recycle, also known as the three R's. We'll be learning all about that in our next lesson. Which of these tips will you use to help fight pollution? Can you think of any other ways individuals can help? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Let's review everything we've learned today. Pollution is the introduction of harmful materials called pollutants into the environment. Most pollution is caused by human activities, such as burning fossil fuels. Pollution can have extremely harmful effects on ecosystems and the environment, but a lot can be done to combat its effects. To learn more about pollution, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. I got some friends to help me clean up the park. With all this help, we'll get it done in no time. Remember, science is all around us. See you next time! Hey, hey.